Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Quote, the reward for work well done is the opportunity to do more. Unquote, Jonah Salk. Once again, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. At last, after months of anticipation and excitement, we are honored to invite you all to the award ceremony of Sri Lanka's first ever Japanese open category virtual talent show, Nihon Star 2021.
皆様、こんばんは。ようこそ、日本スタータレントコンペティションのバーチャル受賞式へ。本日、司会を務めるハルシュニ・グレイです。
私は、ハンシカ・ヘッティアラチです。
My name is Kumudrikuna Tilaka.
I'm Chamud Patirana.
And we will be your hosts for the evening today.
So, Kumudri, I know that Nihon Star is quite the prestigious evening, but would you like telling us more about Nihon Star 2021?
Sure, Samud. I'll tell more about Nihon Star 2021. Nihon Star 2021 consisted of two main categories, which featured participants from various ages up until 25. The categories being the Fine Arts category,where the events were performed live, and the performing arts category, where the participants submitted their videos. The occasion entailed 11 events containing calligraphy, ikebana, origami, kyaraben, creative writing, haiku, singing, dancing, speech, and cosplay. We had over 450 participants for the first round,from which only 120 participants were chosen for the second round. Despite the second round for performing arts being held beforehand, the second round for fine arts were held just today morning. The participants showed immense interest and efforts throughout the series, and today is the day to honor their toil.
It's a matter of great honor and pleasure.To appreciate and reward the hard work of the participants who have made us so proud. Everyone has been working tirelessly across the months to showcase their skills and dedication despite the constraints of virtual environment.
It is only certain that we must recognize such feats and award them for their accomplishments, which we will be doing very soon.
To commence today's proceedings,We cordially invite Mr. Saman Kumara, Director of LNBTI, to welcome the gathering.
Thank you. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Saman Kumar, as the Director of Lanka Nippon District Institute. And on behalf of LNBTI, it's my great pleasure and privilege to welcome all distinguished invitees from Japan and Sri Lanka,for the first ever virtual award ceremony of the Japan Talent Competition. LNBTI, since its inception in 2016, has continuously worked towards offering high-quality academic programs to our students, paving a clear pathway to educate them in Japanese culture and to provide a sound background in information technology. Having recognize the range of opportunities available in Japan, LNBTI offers IT-blended programs with Japanese language proficiency, enabling students to study and work in Japan in the future. LNBTI is a perfect stepping stone to excel in ICT and gain lucrative employment opportunities in Japan or firms in the worldwide.As the next step, LNBTI were able to introduce a Nihon Star Talent Competition among the school students and the general public in Sri Lanka. Main objective of this competition is to create a platform for youth to showcase their talents, which will help them to build a strong, supportive career pathway to Japan and to build a strong community of Sri Lanka youth who appreciate Japanese language and culture. In the first round, we received about 450 participants to perform in the activities to showcase their talents, and 120 participants were shortlisted for the second round, and we selected winners of them. Today, we are going to announce who they are. Even in a pandemic situation like this, we were able to overcome all the challenges with the support of all the participants and the organizers. So we believe that this is the competition was a huge success. As this remarkable occasion awaits commencement, on behalf of LNBTI, it is our honor and privilege to warmly welcome the Honorable Ambassador of the Embassy of Japan in Sri Lanka, His Excellency Mr. Akira Sugiyama, and the Honorable Ambassador of the Embassy of Sri Lanka in Japan, His Excellency Mr. Sanjeev Gunasekara. Your presence today to grace this special occasion is an honor to LNBTI. I would like to take this opportunity to thank you very much for your valuable time to share your knowledge and experience with LNBTI, even with busy schedule. I must express special gratitude to Japanese Embassy in Sri Lanka and the Embassy of Sri Lanka in Japan for continuous support, guidance, and encourage LNBTI to develop education in Sri Lanka. It is my great pleasure to welcome and congratulate all the participants who participated in the Nihon Star competition, their parents and Japanese language teacher who guided them. At the same time, I wish to warmly welcome all academics and officials of our partner universities in Japan, all Japan and Sri Lanka based association in Japan and Sri Lanka. They are Sri Lanka Association Japan, Sri Lanka Academic Association, Sri Lanka Business Council Japan, Sri Lanka Student Association Japan, Sri Lanka Professional Association in Japan, Japanese Business Association, Japanese Graduate Alumni Association, Japanese Language Teachers Association in Sri Lanka, Budo Culture Research and Training Institute. Likewise, at the same time, we would like to warmly welcome Japanese community in Sri Lanka, Sri Lankan community in Japan, all university academics in Sri Lanka, and all officials who are representing University Grant Commission, Ministry of Education, National Institute of Education. And I warmly would like to welcome all officials from Territory and Vocational Education Commission, principals, vice principals, and all the teachers of Sri Lanka schools, Sri Lankan schools, all officials of Japanese Embassy in Sri Lanka, all industrial representatives of LNBTI, advisory board members of LNBTI, all media representatives, and Mr. Hoga Michio, the chairman of LNBTI, and Mr. Dinesh Aparamatu, the deputy chairman of LNBTI, and all the directors of LNBTI, Professor Ananda Kumar, advisor to LNBTI. And I would like to welcome LNBTI students and their parents, LNBTI academics and administration staff members. I warmly welcome all the audience who are here with this special occasion. We were all very impressed by the talent showcased by the competitors of the competition. And we are proud that we are able to create a platform like Nihon Star to enable young generation to demonstrate their talent in arts, culture, and language. All of you, I warmly welcome and enjoy evening, and thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. At LNBTI, we believe in a philosophy beyond simply learning, a shared vision of educating the learners of today to inspire change for a better tomorrow and make dreams possible. To further elucidate its definition, we warmly welcome Mr. Koka Michio, chairman of LNBTI, to speak a few words.
次は社長の小上千代様から LNBTI 大学の指名についてのご説明でございます。小上千代様、お願いいたします。
Thank you for kind introduction, Kumudri andI'm sorry, Ashani. Sorry. I'm Kogai Michio, chairman of LNBTI. Thank you for everyone coming today to our Nihon Star Competition Award ceremony, which is organized by LNBTI. Actually, the first round of the competition started at the end of March this year.Together with more than 800 Sri Lankan youth participants from all over the Sri Lankan country. After the second round of competition that took place 5th August, we were having the final round today in the daytime. Now we are having the Nihon Star Award ceremony in the presence of Mr. Sanjeev Gunasekara,His Excellency, the Sri Lanka Ambassador to Japan, and Mr. Sugiyama Akira, His Excellency, Japanese Ambassador to Sri Lanka. I'm also thankful to many teachers of Japanese language and many Sri Lanka-Japan associations. Without their help,So many participants would not get together to a competition. As Samankumara explained, the primary purpose of the competition is to provide a showcase for Sri Lankan youth who appreciate the rich Japanese culture through the opportunities of their diverse talents.But another important purpose of the competition is to establish a society of Sri Lankan people who are interested in the Japanese culture and to increase in the number of Sri Lankan people who love the Japanese culture. These purposes are in accordance with the purpose of LNBTI itself. The primary purpose of establishing LNBTI is to help Sri Lankan youth to have a job in Japanese industry as professional IT engineers. But another important purpose of LNBTI is to increase in the number of Sri Lankan people who are having lots of interest in the Japanese industry.LNBTI is to be a driving force that gives these Sri Lankan people their greatest forward push and prosperity together with the Japanese industry. I hope many Sri Lankan youth who love the Japanese culture would join LNBTI and contribute to.A good relationship between Sri Lanka and Japan. Thank you for your listening. That's my presentation.
Koga-sama, どうもありがとうございました。
As a student of LNBTI, not only will you receive world-class education, but also experience a culture that empowers you for the challenges of the future.LNBTI fosters the next generation of innovators in the fields of computing by nurturing creativity and the deep desire to harness technology to create a better world. We now invite Mr. Dinesh Saparamadu, Deputy Chairman of LNBTI, to emphasize the importance of LNBTI as a national need.
Good evening, Your Excellency Sugiyama, Ambassador for Japan in Sri Lanka, Your Excellency Sanjeev Gunasekara, Ambassador to Japan, in Ambassador in Japan for Sri Lanka. It is with great pleasure that I welcome all of you, the participants, academics, Your Excellencies, and others to LNBTI Nihon Star Award Ceremony. As mentioned by Koga Michio, our chairman, LNBTI was a dream 5 to 6 years ago. Koga-san and I once met in Japan, and we wanted to build something that we could leave in Sri Lanka for the legacy of our two companies, which is Metatechno and Zenid. That was the initial start of LNBTI. Today, after four and a half years, we have done something that I think truly remarkable. Truly remarkable for both Sri Lanka and for Japan. Sri Lanka would greatly benefit of the knowledge, the culture, as well as the business opportunities that LNBTI would bring into the market. Our students not only will be good in their technical and business knowledge, but also will be global citizens when they learn a culture and another language and go to the world and to work. Our hope is that we build a culture, a conducive environment for collaboration between the two countries. Koga-san and I are deeply committed to the success of LNBTI. And LNBTI directors, their investors, are very much committed to grow LNBTI from strength to strength. One day, we would like to see LNBTI as one of the regional universities that are producing very much of a quality that I would say no par to the world's best universities. And I think, in my humble opinion, we will achieve that because I see the commitment of our staff and our academics. Now, every time I hear great news, I always think and go back to the original vision that we had of building an institute that will produce global citizens, being able to both benefit our country's friendships between the two countries and build a long-lasting relationship between the two countries. With that, I'm not going to take a lot of time because there's a very long program. I wish all the participants, award winners, and most of all, the people who are behind this organizing it, building a program, executing a program like this, it's not a small task, especially during a time of pandemic. But I think our team and you deserve a great applause for doing that. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Next, let's all have a nice seat and enjoy the video selected as the best Japanese song for Nihon Star 2021.
Minasama, kore kara Nihon Star Talent Competition no saiyoushu sakuhin toshite erabereta uta o garan kudasai.
Minasan, 20 te yuki go gosonji desu ka? 30 nen mae ni tanjou shi, ima demo hoiku no genba ya shougakko nado de utawarete iru yo. Dewa, kiite mite kudasai ne.
was gorgeous. A job well done for all participants of the category. I think that was a lovely example of just how beautiful the bond between Japan and Sri Lanka can be. Speaking of bonds, we would like to take this instance to invite the Honorable Ambassador of Japan in Sri Lanka, His Excellency, Mr. Akira Sugiyama, to educate us on the importance of strengthening the bond between Japan and Sri Lanka.
次はスリランカの日本大使、杉山アキラ大使閣下より、日本とスリランカの絆を強める重要性についてのご説明でございます。杉山アキラ様、お願いいたします。
Thank you very much for waiting. His Excellency Sanjeev Gunasekara, Ambassador of Sri Lanka to Japan, Mr. Koga Michio, Chairman of the LNBTI, Mr. Dinesh Saparmadu, Deputy Chairman, LNBTI, Mr. Saman Kumara, Director of LNBTI, Professor Ananda Kumara, Advisor of the LNBTI, distinguished academic staff, fellow students and parents from LNBTI and other schools. Good evening, Aibuan, Wanakam, and Konbanwa. Thank you very much for inviting me to the Nihon Star Awards ceremony this evening. I visited the LNBTI in 2019 to join the Japanese Culture Festival, the Japanese Day. It is my great pleasure to be back virtually this time to the LNBTI. First, I'd like to commend Mr. Koga, chairman of the LNBTI, and his team for organizing this event successfully in the midst of unprecedented challenges posed by COVID-19. And congratulations to the participants of the Japanese language teaching training program for finishing the course, and the fellow students for being selected as awardees for their work of Japanese art and Japanese performing art. IT experts, especially young ones, are expected to be in high demand in Japan. According to the recent survey by the Ministry of Economy, Trade and Industry of Japan on the supply and demand of IT human resources, the shortage of IT engineers in Japan will reach a maximum of 790,000 over the next 10 years. This result shows that the IT industry is not an exception when it comes to the shortage of labor force in Japan due to the aging population. I believe that foreign IT professionals will play a critical role in filling this gap, especially because Japanese IT companies, which increasingly seek business opportunities in overseas markets, are in need of highly skilled foreign IT experts. In addition, in Japan, IT engineers are in their 30s in average, relatively younger compared with other engineers. Thus, as you see, there is high demand for young IT professionals in Japan. Sri Lankan IT engineers are highly acclaimed in the world. For instance, As I understand, a Sri Lankan IT firm has provided an electronic trading system for the London Stock Exchange in the UK. I am sure that more Japanese IT companies will be interested in hiring Sri Lankan IT engineers. I believe that the LNBTI will contribute to producing excellent IT engineers expected to work in Japan by providing unique curriculum, combining IT education and Japanese language training. As the chairman and the deputy chairman of the LNBTI has just explained. Since Japanese companies place high importance on Japanese language skills when hiring foreign IT engineers, LNBTI graduates who have acquired both high-level IT expertise and Japanese language skills would match the demand of such Japanese companies. When I joined the LNBTI's Japanese Culture Festival back in 2019, I was very much impressed by the LNBTI students' enthusiastic interest in learning Japanese culture. Today, I have just heard the wonderful performance of Japanese song, and I look forward to the upcoming performance of Japanese art later in the program. I hope that the LNBTI students will deepen their understanding of Japanese culture, which will definitely help them study and work better in Japan. For your information, next year, 2022, will mark the 70th anniversary of the establishment of diplomatic relations between Japan and Sri Lanka. Availing to the fullest the powerful momentum of this landmark year, we hope to work together to further strengthen our bilateral relationship, including friendly people-to-people exchanges between our two countries. Last but not least, I would like to reiterate that the Japanese Embassy will continue to extend support for the LNBTI's valuable activities, which contribute to enhancing mutual understanding and between our two countries. Thank you very much for your kind attention.
Sugiyama Akira Taishi Kakka, doumo arigato gozaimashita.
Thank you, sir. And now, for the distribution of our first batch of certificates for the evening. These certificates are a reflection of the dedication put forth by the teachers who participated in the Japanese language teacher training program. We humbly request Professor Ananda Kumar, Director of Academic Affairs at LNBTI, to hand over the tokens of appreciation in lieu of our gratitude.
Good afternoon, everybody. LNBTI, as the first and only Japanese higher education institute in Sri Lanka, wishes to assist to further strengthen the relationship between Japan and Sri Lanka. In fact, we have realized that there's a growing interest among the young Sri Lankans to learn about Japan. Many schools offered courses on Japanese language. Nevertheless, as a country which is not so familiar with Japanese characters and the language itself, we can understand the pain for either teaching or learning the Japanese language in a country like Sri Lanka. As such, LNBTI has taken several initiatives to improve the current situation. I'm happy to announce today that we recently completed an intensive Japanese teacher training program. This program was conducted by Professor Natsuko Ikeda of the Faculty of Foreign Studies, Meijō University, for which I was the founding dean. There were many teachers who joined this program from various schools throughout the country, and more than 80 teachers successfully completed the program. We believe that the teachers who attended this program would be able to conduct Japanese language classes more effectively than before. I'd like to express our sincere thanks to the University of Kalania, National Institute of Education, for their great assistance to conduct this training program. One special word of appreciation is extended to Professor Ikeda for the hard work done during a 3-month period to conduct this program. Let me take this opportunity to inform you that in addition to the Japanese language teacher training program, we have been assisting teachers of science and mathematics subjects as well with the cooperation of experts from both Japan and Sri Lanka. We will try to provide more opportunities for upgrading the knowledges of both students and teachers. Especially, opportunities will be created to transfer knowledges from Japan. There are many things for us to learn from Japan. LNBTI would be willing to work with all of you to strengthen the relationship with Japan. Now, I would like to request our staff to introduce the teachers who participated to the Japanese language teacher training program. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. With the technology advancement and vacancies for labor in Japan, young professionals who are interested in Japan have greater prospects in getting into the Japanese job market. This has expanded the set of opportunities that one can invest into if interested in Japan. On that note, we cordially invite the Honorable Ambassador of Sri Lanka in Japan, His Excellency, Mr. Sanjeev Gunasekara, to discuss about the opportunities in Japan for young professionals.
Sangiva, Nihon no Sri Lanka Taishi, Sanjeev Gunasekara Taishi Kakka Yori, Wakai Senmonka ni Taisuru, Nihon dono Kikkai ni Suite, Speech wo Anigai Itashimasu.
Good evening, everybody. His Excellency Ambassador Sugiyama, Chairman Mr. Koga, Vice Chairman Mr. Sapramadu, Professor Ananda Kumara, distinguished guests, academicians, staff, and most importantly, the students. As the Ambassador mentioned before, Japan is a developed country, and as a result, has a very advanced economy. And as a developed country and an advanced economy, any country wants that economy to grow. and with looking at the demographics of Japan with its aging population, Japan is actively encouraging and welcoming talented young professionals. So saying that, especially what is pertinent today in the areas of information technology, in the software field, hardware, electronics, Japan is a leader in the world. And as a result, they are looking for people, even in the movie industry, anime, AI, robotics, they're looking for students in this field to come and assist this economy grow. Saying that, there's a program called the Highly Skilled Foreign Professionals Program. That's based on a point system. And this Highly Skilled Foreign Professional Program, which gives fast track preferential treatment to young talent, to talent, has three sections. One is in the academic and research field. The other field is the specialized technical field, which you all will most probably fall into. And the other category is the business management field. So based on this point system, especially in the specialized technical field, they give you points based on the education qualification, which is a degree, master's, you get a high amount of points. Also, your years of experience, also your age. The highest points are for talent that is under 29 years. Also, the remuneration package. Higher the package, you get a high amount of points. So in a summary, this is a program just like in Australia and Canada. If you are a young professional with qualification and talent, you have a place in Japan. Saying that, this information is available in the immigration website, in the Japanese immigration website, anybody can access this. Also, I was just checking this morning, the jobs available in Japan for foreign professionals. There are, as the ambassador mentioned before, there are a whole list of jobs available. You can try the JETRO website. JETRO stands for Japan External Trade Organization. JETRO has a website for foreign professionals. You can go in there, you can type your field, you can even narrow the search by putting the area in Japan where you like to live, and it'll narrow down and search the jobs, and it even gives you a tab where if you only know English, English only speaking jobs. But in Japan, me being in Japan, I would highly recommend to learn Japanese before coming to Japan. It's helpful. Also, there's a tab on the Japanese embassy website called Job Opportunities, open for professionals. There's a tab called Open for Professionals in the Japanese Embassy Sri Lanka website, which has a whole lot of information and which will be helpful to people who are seeking to get opportunities in Japan. I hope this short information was helpful. And if you all need any additional information, please feel free to contact my mission via on the web, slembassyjapan.com. And I want to again, finally, congratulate the award recipients today. Congratulations. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Those at LNBTI are constantly exposed to Japanese culture whilst pursuing our education, hence allowing us flexibility in managing two contrasting yet harmonizing sectors. For further elucidation, we warmly welcome Dr. Tilak Chaminder, Head of Academic Affairs at LNBTI, to brief us regarding the inauguration of LNBTI's Japanese Society.
Good evening, all distinguished guests who have participated to Nihon Star Award Ceremony. Thank you very much for letting me to share the golden opportunity which will be awarded to Sri Lankan community through the Lanka Nippon Association for Enhancement of Culture and Technology. So as we mentioned from the beginning, from the beginning of the LNBTI, so we have done so many activities to enhance the relationship between Japan and Sri Lanka. So likewise, so we are having so many objectives to implement this nature of association. So some of the objectives of this association are to strengthen the bonds between Sri Lanka and Japan, and for the mutual development of people of both countries through the exchange of cultural values, to create a platform for Sri Lankans to develop and showcase their diverse talents related to Japan, an exchange of technical knowledge for the development of industry and academia, support expanding learning and working opportunities, especially in Japan. So those are some of our objectives of implementing this nature of association in Sri Lanka. So through this association, like we are willing to provide few membership categories. So we would like to invite all of you also to take part in this association, as we believe that all of you are fans of Japan. So according to the slide we have shown here, so there are a few categories, especially as advisory, professional, student, and general. For the advisory category, we expect the people who are joining, like they should be senior professionals and academics who are in the capacity of guiding others in getting the benefits of Japanese culture and technologies. And then in the professional category, we are welcoming the individuals with professional qualifications and work experiences, like who are having special interest in Japan. Under the student category, we are welcoming school and university students who are having interest in Japan. And under the general category, we are welcoming anyone who is interested in Japanese culture and technology. So I believe that all of you are also fans of Japan, lovers of Japan. So we welcome all of you to take part in our association. So I think most of the guests who have joined with today's session know well, like what kind of opportunities we are giving for the Sri Lankan community through LNBTI. So likewise, all the members of LNBTI, we are giving this kind of opportunities, like ability to interact and network with Japan lovers, ability to improve knowledge on Japanese culture and technology, opportunities for the research and development, guidance on career opportunities in Japan, guidance on scholarship opportunities in Japan, interact with various Japanese counterparts, get information about job opportunities in Japan, get information about study opportunities in Japan, as well as apply for scholarship opportunities provided by LNBTI. So not only that, like there will be many more opportunities in the coming years. So we will like educate and we will let you know about those opportunities. So I would like to share some of our past experiences, like in order to like let you know like what kind of activities we have done up to now, and to show the capacity of doing such activities in large scale in Sri Lanka. So you can see like some kind of like free seminars have been arranged like this in various schools, like for the school students and then the general community. So by the Japanese university professors as well as the professionals of Japan. There were various seminars like for the general public and the young the generation, so on various the technical areas. So, and not only that, so like there were various kind of seminars to develop their communication skills as well. So we have arranged this nature of like large scale seminars in many schools in all around the Sri Lanka for the to improve the knowledge of our Sri Lankan students. So we have done lots of workshops in various technical areas like this, as you have seen in this slides. So here you can see Some sponsorships also have been given to many schools, like for their technical days or the Japanese language day. So likewise, we have given a lot of sponsorships and awards for the students and the schools. So you can, as you can see in this slide, so I think almost all our the teachers who are joining with this session knows, like we are conducting annual teachers get together. So since year 2017, so we would like to welcome you in like future years also to LNBTI to participate our teacher get togethers and strengthen the relationship between the teachers. And we have arranged like various kind of workshops for the teachers as well. So recently we conducted a workshop with the Budo Culture Research and Training Institute. So with the participation of a lot of the Japanese language teachers. And we are annually publishing a Japanese cultural magazine called Hinamaru. So we are continuously doing that as one of our main event of LNBTI in order to develop the Japanese cultural exposure among the students. And we have arranged a lot of awareness sessions and cultural exchange programs with Japanese schools and the Japanese universities. So most of the university students as well as the students in schools got a lot of opportunities to interact with Japanese students through LNBTI. And we have arranged a lot of free workshops on IoT, robotics, embedded systems. Likewise, a lot of arrangements have been done in order to improve the technical knowledge of Sri Lankan the community with the support of Japanese government. So in this year also, we have arranged the similar kind of program. So I think lots of Sri Lankan young generation have been joined with such programs with LNBTI. And not only that, so we have arranged a lot of awareness seminars on job opportunities and then the way of doing business in Japan. So the best practices in Japan, so that the cultural values of Japan likewise. So this nature of workshops have been arranged for the community many times at LNBTI. So here, and not only that, so we have offered a lot of scholarships for the students who have got a lot of high ranking in the A-level kind of examinations in Sri Lanka. So recently we gave a 100% scholarship for one of our best students who were selected as the first ranked student in the Sri Lankan A-level examination. And then we have done a lot of awareness sessions about continuing their career in Japan. So especially how to study and then how to continue the life and then how to join with jobs likewise. So we have done a lot of awareness sessions for the nation. So likewise, you can see a lot of sessions have been done in many schools all around the country and the Japanese days in order to enhance the cultural values of the Japan. So this kind of Japanese talent competitions also have been arranged in the Japanese teacher training program was conducted successfully in this year. So we want to continue the same in coming years as well. So we have given opportunities for our students to visit Japan and without spending any amount. So as a scholarship, we have given such opportunities for our students. So I would like to invite all of you to take part in this opportunity. And we would like to invite all of you in future to join with this association in order to get the benefits of that. So thank you very much for the given opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Yet again, we have another delightful video. Let's all enjoy the video selected as the best Japanese dance for Nihon Star 2021.
皆様、これから日本スタータレントコンペティションに最優秀作品として選ばれた踊りをご覧ください。
That was a spectacular performance, ladies and gentlemen. As a premier higher education institute, LNBTI is conducted in a manner distinctively different from other institutions, drawing from the advanced technological background of Japanese roots. We now invite Professor Ananda Kumara, Director of Academic Affairs for LNBTI, to speak about how LNBTI nurtures students for Japan.
Sugiwa, Ananda Kumara Kyaju Kara, LNBTI wa danayani, Nihon Kigiana Tameni, Sri Lankan Gakseya, Sateterukuni Suitena, Ohanashi de Gasaimas, Ananda Kumara Sama, Onegai Tashimas.
Good afternoon, everybody, once again. You have heard a lot of good news from both His Excellency ambassadors for Sri Lanka in Japan and for Japan in Sri Lanka, from Sri Lanka. Yes, at the LNBTI, we provide you IT education. Why is it? The answer is very simple, because there is a very bright future for IT graduates, both locally in Sri Lanka as well as abroad. Actually, why we promote Japan? In fact, Japan is a country which was not so easy for our professionals to get jobs in the past. But nowadays, as our His Excellency ambassadors explained to you very clearly, there are very good opportunities in Japan also, provided that you have gained required skills. So the thing is that Japan does not accept labor for foreigners for manual labor jobs, but they respect skilled labor, skilled people, whose skills are required for Japan. Actually, how is the situation of IT sector jobs in Japan? The demand for IT or ICT or IoT, so either one of these words are referring to the IT technology, information technology. The demand for this IT has been increasing very rapidly, but the problem is that the labor supply for the IT industry within the country, within Japan, is decreasing. And again, at the number of jobs is increasing very rapidly. As such, this is the best time for you to think about Japan to work in the IT sector. So in fact, you may be aware about the latest concept for Japan, Society 5.0. I have prepared a very short video related to the Society 5.0. Just have a look here.
ここはちょっと未来の日本のとある町。時間ぴったり。IoT や AI 技術によって叶えられる Society 5.0 の社会です。
おはよう。朝ごはん何にし
よう。ご主人はいかがですか。
いいね。
そろそろお出かけの時間です。
よっ。クロケパンとミックスサンド、いつものお店でお願い。
注文しておきます。
昨日から血圧が高いみたいですが。
あら、そう。
お待ちしてきます。
いってらっしゃい。
Yes, this is actually a image about the future Japanese society, but there are many activities which have already been introduced to the society just even today. Japan is a country which pays a very high attention to the R&D activities and also practical applications. So introduce many applications. That is a very common practice for Japan. Actually, if you look at this car is on now auto drive mode. So that means even though you sit on the driving seat, there is no need to touch the steering wheel at a certain point, provided that the vehicle is on the autopilot mode. So even though some of these are very images about how the technology will improve in the future, but there are many products which are also in the market even now. Many car industries have introduced a similar kind of cars with auto-driving facilities even today. Actually, what is behind all these new developments? That is IT or IoT or information industry. Okay, so Japan is a high-tech country, we all know about that. Very good attractive jobs are available in various industries in Japan. Actually, as our ambassadors explained, skilled jobs are available in many areas of activities, economic and industrial activities, not only in the manufacturing sector, but in the agriculture and the services sector as well. So what we can do from Japan, actually our model at the LNBTI, that is to study in Sri Lanka, and after you complete your study, you will get a job in Japan as an IT professional. So why we emphasize on IT sector. Actually, there were many elaborations so far, but I would like to emphasize once again, there's a huge labor shortage in the IT professional category in Japan. And foreign professionals can easily join the IT sector if you get the right training, which is necessary to work in Japan. Actually, this is data which is relating to this story, what we have been talking so far. In fact, this data is referring from 2010 up to 2030. And this is the demand curve. So that means the demand for IT industry, IT jobs, will increase very rapidly in the future. Even though the economy, Japan economy, does not perform very well. So there will be 410,000 jobs by the year 2030. And if it works well, there will be 790,000 IT jobs in Japan in total. But the local supply, the light blue bars here, it will decrease from after 2019, according to the estimates. So we are trying to enter this category. So that means LNBTI graduates will be able to get jobs in this category, which is lacking in Japan. So labor is missing over there. So if we supply the proper skills necessary for Japan, so that means what are those skills? First of all, education and qualification should be there. So that is available at the LNBTI directly. And in addition, Japanese language ability will be provided to you. And more than that, understanding about the Japanese society. Actually, this is not a society which is thinking or acting like America or Australia or UK, like European countries. But there is a particular way of thinking and doing work here. So we will give you all these things at the LNBTI. So if you acquire those skills required for Japan, you can become a very good partner, a very good contributor for both Japan and Sri Lanka. Actually, your life also will be very much happier if you can contribute to both Sri Lanka and Japan this way. And I will show you some examples of IT or IoT or ICT. Actually, this robotics area is a very important area and very demanding. And you can see robots in automobile industry or even the service industry. So this robot will be singing actually. And so service robots will be everywhere. In fact, in the airports, you can see this kind of robotics and robots, and even in the in some companies, you can see the same thing. All these things will be there in Japan, but what is behind? So that is the point. What is behind? It is the IT or ICT skills. Now, even for medicine, telemedicine is becoming a very interesting area in the near future. Now, you can easily imagine what would happen during this pandemic area like Corona. So from your home, you can get the proper treatment with this high-tech environment. So I will show you one very simple example about how robots can contribute to us. I will shorten the video because of the time limitation. This robot was available in the Toyota Museum in Nagoya. So that is these are some of the examples, and then again about the salaries in Japan. So these are average salaries according to the professionals, and of course, as you know, the salaries depend on the type of skills you have or your profession, and this is the category we are targeting. So it's about 104 lakhs per year in the IT sector, IT engineers, IoT engineers, so like that. So if you further study and become a lecturer in a university or a professor in a university with a very good research background and experience, your salaries will be very much higher. That kind of a country Japan is. So according to the ages also, of course, the salaries will vary. And even at your young ages, you can achieve this kind of, you can have this kind of a salary in Japan. So once you gain some experience and once you become matured, your salary will be very much higher. Actually, these are some average salaries. Average means some may get more and some may get low. It depends on your ability. And if you work very hard, you can reach to the maximum. And actually, if you look through all this information, you can easily understand that in the technical IT sector, there are many very good jobs, and your salaries will be very high, and your social contribution through the work will be very much of satisfaction to you and to your family and also to the society. So in general, it is very difficult for you to go to Japan for professional jobs. But if you provided that all the skills needed for Japan, not only the basic subject, but the Japanese knowledge, as well as the understanding about the Japanese society and Japanese working atmosphere, you can get a very good job in Japan and become successful. So once again, reminding you what you want to become successful as a professional in Japan, you will get all these things at the LNBTI. So our model is study at LNBTI and work in Japan, job in Japan. And this is the first time for Sri Lankan to offer this opportunity. But of course, if you want to study in a Japanese university also as a part of your whole study program, that is also available. And thank you very much. And I wish you will become successful in both Sri Lanka and Japan by understanding this kind of information and gaining this kind of skills. Thank you very much.
Ananda Kumara-sama, domo arigatou gozaimashita. Sate, Nihon Star Talent Competition ni sanka shita gakusei tachi no noruku to ima made no ii omoi de wo mite mimasen ka? Sore de wa omoi de no video wo otanoshimi kudasai.
During the progression of this competition, across the past 6 months, we can agree that most of us made unforgettable memories together. Let's now take a moment to share and appreciate those beautiful memories.
A Nihon Star Japanese Talent Competition 2021. At LNBTI, we held the Nihon Star Talent Competition as a platform to let Sri Lankan Japanese language students showcase their talents. Students competed under performing arts and the fine arts categories. Participants in the performing arts category took part in singing, dancing, speech, cosplay, and rakugo. Under fine arts, we had calligraphy, origami, ikebana, haiku, kiarapen, and creative writing competitions. Participants performed live for the fine arts category on 19th April, and performing arts participants' video submissions closed on 17th April. Participants selected for the second round were announced shortly, and the second round ended on 5th August. We found many promising young talents through Nihon Star. So let's enjoy some of the awesome performances from our contestants.
Hello, hello, excuse me. Any good restaurant here? Good restaurant.
English? Oh, this street, walk please. Hamburger, beef tiki, omurice, garlic sauce, juice, good taste. A coffee shop. Coffee, coffee zeri, grapefruit juice, piment, tomato, cheese, sand, good taste. Over there, pan shop, coroke pan, melon pan, gratin pan. Good paradise. Let's go.
What?
McDonald's.
I foreigner, I don't speak Japanese, but I love Aoi Sora. When you say wakarimashita, I say Hitachi, Toyota, Kawasaki, Nintendo, and also Nihonga. I'm losing my way.
Oh, where should I go?
Shinjuku Sobei.
I need a Doraemon.
You speak Japanglish.
And show me more language.
What can I do? Where should I go?
私の大好きな人
Thank you.
ました。最初の日本語のクラスで、日本の先生は日本語には文字が3つあります。それはひらがなとカタカナと漢字です。まずひらがなとカタカナを勉強しましょうと教えてくれました。先生の話を聞いて私はびっくりしました。どうしてかというと、シンハラ語には一つの文字しか。
どうか Can you keep my
Those were some wonderful memories indeed. Thank you to all the participants for all your lovely contributions. And now for the much awaited distribution of awards and certificates for Nihon Star 2021.
Wow, I can feel the excitement. After all, everyone did such an amazing job. I heard that judges had a tough time choosing from the assortment of talents.
You are certainly right, Chamud. That's why we would be giving everyone who participated in Nihon Star 2021 a participation certificate to appreciate their efforts. After all, for us, everyone is a winner.
Then, without further delay, let's announce the winners of Nihon Star 2021.
The winners of Nihon Star 2021. Winners of the Fine Arts category. Our first category being calligraphy. In third place, we have
Dumitu Shanilka, St. Aloysius College, Ratnapura.
Second place, we have
G.V. Nisandi Chatma, Panadir Balika Mahavidyalaya.
At first place in the calligraphy competition, we have
R.I. Vikram Singha, Trinity College, Kandy.
Congratulations to all the winners of the calligraphy category. Next up, we have the Ikebana category. In third place, we have
EWS Rashmika L-Level Sumana Balika Vidyalaya Radnapura.
Second place, we have
GV Nisandi Chatma Panadur Balika Mahavidyalaya.
And in first place of the Ikebana category, we have
MMIA Mapa Ratnavali Balika Vidyalaya Gampaha.
Congratulations to all winners of the Ikebana category. Next, origami. In third place, we have
Litasa Dayananda Visakha Vidyalaya Colombo.
Second place, we have
T.A. Sakuni Nimesha Ovitikama Bodhiraja College.
And in first place under the origami category, we have
Sandali Ravisha Sujata Vidyalaya Mataru.
Congratulations to all the winners of the origami category. Caravan. In third place, we have
MMIA Mapa Ratnavali Balika Vidyalaya Gampaha.
Second place, we have
Team Kizuna.
And in first place in the Caribbean category, we have
BD Baba Santi Aisharya Sumana Balika Vidyalaya Ratnapura.
Congratulations to all the winners under the Caribbean category. Next up, the creative writing category. In third place, we have
LW Oshadi Mahamaya Kolonna Balika Vidyalaya.
Second place, we have
WW Hiroshi Netara Ferguson High School, Ratnapura.
And in first place under the creative writing category, we have
W Nihara Devindini Sumana Balika Vidyalaya, Ratnapura.
Congratulations to all the winners under the creative writing category. Haiku. In second place, we have
K.A. Rashani Layanga, Sumana Balika Vidyalaya, Ratnapura.
First place under the Haiku category, we have
Leonage Isurika Chamindi, University of Kelaniya.
Congratulations to all winners. Next up, the winners of the Performing Arts category. Speech in Japanese. In third place, we have
Jitmi Avindi, Sri Pali College, Horena.
Second place, we have
Purna Rusiru, D.S. Senanayake College, Colombo.
At first place under the Speech in Japanese category, we have
Navodaya Dhananjani, Sri Pali College, Horena.
Congratulations to all the winners under the Speech in Japanese category. Next, the winners for the solo category under dancing. In third place, we have
Hiruni Vijayasena, Musius College, Colombo.
Second place, we have
Yamashi Ekanayak, St. Joseph Balika Mahavidyalaya, Kegol.
The winner of the solo category under dancing is
Misha Hansi Devamini Yasodhara Devi Balika Vidyalaya Gampaha.
Congratulations to all the winners under the solo dancing category. Next, the group category under dancing. In third place, we have
Ravinetra Dancing Group.
Second place, we have
Team Itoko.
And in first place under the group dancing category, we have
Zen Bon Zakura.
Congratulations to all the winners under the group dancing category. Next, we have the solo category under singing. In third place, we have
Netmi Navoda, Ferguson High School, Ratnapura.
Second place, we have
Nilasi Lihansa, Musius College, Colombo.
First place, we have
Panchali Pereira, Visoka Vidyalaya, Sapugaskanda.
Congratulations to all the winners under the solo singing category. Next, we have the group category under singing. In third place, we have
Futaga Nikko Nikko.
Second place, we have
Team Akira.
And in first place, under the group singing category, we have
Team Just the Two of Us.
Congratulations to all the winners under the singing group category. In cosplay category, the first place goes to
Vojani Gathari, Ratnavali Balika Vidyale Gampaha.
Congratulations, Vojani. And here's a big congratulations going out from LNBTI to all the participants as well as the winners of Nihon Star 2021. Thank you.
Thank you, Harshini and Kumudri. As we reach the final moments of Nihon Star 2021, we cordially invite Dr. Tilak Chaminder, Head of Academic Affairs at LNBTI, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Thank you. Very good evening again. As Head of Academic Affairs of LNBTI, I was pleasantly surprised by the talents displayed by the contestants in the competition. And we are pleased that we were able to devise a platform like the Nihon Star to let our young generation exhibit their Japanese cultural skills. Firstly, let me thank the Honorable Ambassador of the Embassy of Japan in Sri Lanka, His Excellency Mr. Akira Sugiyama, and the Honorable Ambassador of the Embassy of Sri Lanka in Japan, His Excellency Mr. Sanjeev Gunasekara, for taking their valuable time to join Nihon Star and motivate our contestants. Secondly, I would like to thank the officials of our partner universities in Japan, Sri Lankan University Academics, officials from University Grant Commission, Ministry of Education, National Institute of Education, Tertiary and Vocational Education Commission, and the officials from the embassies. Let me also extend my thank to Japan and Sri Lanka-based associations, such as Sri Lankan Association Japan, Sri Lankan Academic Association, Sri Lanka Business Council Japan, Sri Lanka Student Association Japan, Sri Lanka Professional Association in Japan, Japanese Business Association, and Japanese Graduate Alumni Association, Japanese Language Teachers Association, and Budo Culture Research and Training Institute. I take this opportunity to express my gratitude to the principals, vice principals, and the teachers of schools for being here today and for the effort they took to improve the skills we have witnessed today. A huge thank also goes to LNBTI industry partners who are collaborating with us on training our students and transferring industry-specific knowledge to our students. I am grateful for the guidance from board members and the directors of LNBTI. Nihon Star wouldn't have been a success without the contributions of LNBTI students and their parents and LNBTI academics and administration staff members. I thank you all. Last but not least, I would like to thank and congratulate all our contestants for their participation in this event and entertaining us with their talents, their teachers and parents for encouraging and supporting them. We are excited to meet all of you again with Nihon Star Season 2 in 2022. I wish all of you a pleasant evening. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Quote, successful people are not gifted. They just work hard and then succeed on purpose. Unquote. Anonymous. With that, ladies and gentlemen, the days of anticipation and excitement has finally come to an end. The music and dance have colored this quiet evening in a myriad of hues and song, and it couldn't have been done without our wonderful audience. We once again thank you for taking time off of your busy schedules to join us tonight at Nihon Star 2021.
このパンデミックの中でも、このイベントに前向きに協力していただいたことを嬉しく思います。
皆様、最後までどうもありがとうございました。
Thank you for having us tonight. Once again, I'm Kumudri Gunatilaka.
I'm John Patrana.
私は Harshini Kure です。
私は Hansika Hettiarachi です。
A lovely night. You may now leave the meeting. Thank you.